Hello everybody and welcome to another War Thunder upcoming content video. We've got another Naval Forces video today on the 12th of September, 2022. This is a new light cruiser for the German Bluewater fleet tech tree, the SMS Elbing, or proper pronunciation, I am not aware. The SMS Elbing is the second of two German World War I era cruisers of that class, previously ordered by the Imperial Russian Navy, which were seized at the outbreak of the Great War. Soon, SMS Elbing will reinforce the early German cruiser lineup as it makes its way into War Thunder as part of the Drone Age major update. So briefly, it's a German World War I era light cruiser, initially built for the Russian Navy and outfitted with powerful 150mm guns. So the SMS Elbing is a light cruiser for Germany of the third rank. It features powerful cannons, torpedoes, but it has low protection and lacks anti-air guns. I will start by saying that I thoroughly enjoy this classic style of cruiser vessel ship with the multiple funnels. It just looks so old school and really classic and iconic looking. So it's got that going for it in terms of its visuals. Here's some history on the unit if you are interested to know more about how it came to be. And here we've got some screenshots of the vessel. So it looks like it has single gun mounts scattered across. It looks like it's going to have 8 total guns, if I'm not mistaken, just by counting there. So in War Thunder, the SMS Elbing will be a new light cruiser docking at rank 3 of the German Bluewater fleet following the release of the next major update. Becoming one of the earliest light cruisers new captains will be able to unlock in the German naval tree, the SMS Elbing will help smooth out the transition for captains moving up from destroyers to larger and more powerful vessels. Upon obtaining this ship, captains will immediately take note of the much heavier firepower present on this ship when compared to most German destroyers that they may have captained before. Instead of 12.7cm guns, captains now have access to 8 of the much more powerful 15cm guns, thus enabling them to not only deal greater damage to smaller vessels, but also to effectively take on other cruisers with armor-piercing ammunition. However, it's worth noting that only 4 guns can be brought to bear on a broadside, with the 5th gun enabled at proper course angles. In addition, SMS Elbing's arsenal is also complemented by 4 52mm utility cannons, as well as a pair of 500mm torpedo launchers, mounted on either side of the ship respectively. In contrast to SMS Elbing's excellent firepower, the warship's protection remains a bit lackluster. This is the first armored deck cruiser to the game. She lacks the armored belt, keeping the armor inside the hull as a 20mm horizontal deck with 40mm side plates. This layout protects the ship's vital modules from salvos of high explosive rounds up to 150mm or 6 inch, and armor-piercing rounds of up to 105mm or 6 inches. The steering room has much better protection of 80mm of armor. Fun fact, the SMS Elbing was the first German cruiser to be armed with 15cm guns. However, thanks to its rather modest displacement and powerful propulsion system, capable of generating 30,000 horsepower, SMS Elbing can reach a sound top speed of 27.5 knots, or 51 kilometers an hour. As a result, aspiring captains of this warship won't need to worry about lagging behind their allies, but captains also shouldn't expect to lead the charge either. Yet, after considering the ship's protection, this may not be such a bad thing after all. If anything, sticking closer to its allies will boost SMS Elbing's odds of repelling an air attack, given its lack of own anti-air batteries. And here we've got some screenshots of the vessel. Nice side shot, that's a nice profile, I like that. So this will be coming to the game very soon with the next major update, which, like I said in the recent video, should be at some point very soon. But if you have not been paying attention to the news, there is a ton of other content that has been shown off. For naval forces alone, we have the new United States blue water vessel, the USS Alaska CB-1 large cruiser or battle cruiser, depending on your classification. The Russians are getting a new modernized light cruiser for their tech tree as well. And then over here, we've got the new Andrea Doria, which is a new dreadnought for the Italian Naval Forces tech tree. And now, of course, we've got the new German ship, light cruiser, that's coming. There's been a lot of helicopter content shown off. The Chinese get a full tech tree of various helicopters from the Z-9 to the Z-10 and Z-19. The British are getting a South African premium, the Royfalk Mark 1F CSH, for their tech tree. And the Italians are getting a bundle pack for a Turkish T-129 attack as well for their tech tree. So lots of exciting stuff there that's been shown off. Of course, Ground Forces has quite a few different things coming as well. We have, just to name a few here, the new German VK-3002M, a prototype Panther tank. The Swedish are getting the PBV-302 Bill, which is an ATGM carrier with an automatic gun on it. We have the new Chinese HJ-9, as it's called there, but it's the AT, which is coming for their tech tree. It's a wheeled ATGM carrier. The Italian tech tree is getting a new premium bundle pack, the Spanish VRCC Centauro, so that's quite exciting. The British tech tree gets access to the Skink, a Sherman with four 20mm auto guns on it for taking down aircraft. The Russians get a new squadron tank, the T-80 UK. The Swedish tech tree gets access to a new Leopard vehicle, as well as tank crews being updated for Swedish and Japanese crews. And then we have some new maps, including Pradesh for ground forces, and then we also have the Golden Bay location for naval forces. And then we have some new effects, like aircraft engine fire extinguishers, which is actually a new feature on a few helicopters and aircraft or planes. We have entirely new visual effects for explosions and ammo detonations, etc. Of course, we've got drones, which brings strike drones and scout drones to the game. And then last but not least, we have planes, which have gotten the least amount of news thus far, which includes the French Mirage 2000 CS-5 jet fighter that's coming, and the Russian Su-25 plus its Su-25K premium counterpart, which means so far we've officially, on the dev blog, only been shown 3 planes overall. We've been shown more helicopters than we have been shown planes for the next major update, which is quite shocking to me, but either way, there is a very heavy focus on helicopter and ground forces with this update, at least so far. But other than that, I'll see you guys in the next War Thunder upcoming content video. Goodbye.